Hi, I'm Charlie. Welcome back, swordofsurvival.com. And for those hunters out there and bird lovers, you probably already recognize that sound. And that was the sound of a quail. And what I'm going to do on this episode here is show you how to make your own quail call when you're out in an emergency situation, or even if you're just playing around wanting to make one for calling your birds in when you're hunting or something. But you can use this in conjunction with the box trap. One of my other episodes that I did, if you're trying to catch quail, you can use this quail call here to call them in and get them closer to your traps. I made this out of, again, one of my favorite desert bushes is the yucca. What you want to do is use a yucca branch or stalk from the plant that's not really too dead and not really too green. Sort of right in between. It makes it perfect. You want to get a stalk that's probably about a half inch in diameter, maybe 3/8. And you want to cut your section off about maybe 3 inches long. In this situation here, I happen to have rubber bands. I'll show you here up close. The thick type of rubber bands, that's what I'm using for a reed on the inside. Okay? And on the outside, I use smaller diameter rubber bands to hold it together once I've got it in tune. So let me give you a quick demonstration here on how to do this. I'll go ahead and zoom in on my little station here. Okay, once you have your stalk, you want to take a piece of wood or something that you can cut you about a 3-inch section off. So, save the rest of this in case you mess this one up, you can start over again. And what you're going to do is that, once you have it cut, go ahead and shave off some of that outer bark, make it kind of smooth, since it's going to be, you're going to be putting it up to your lips and you don't want to get any splinters or anything like that up in your kissing machine. Say kissing machine. That's kind of corny, ain't it? Anywho, go ahead and while you have it like this, go ahead and shave some of that dead stuff off the outside. Then what you want to do is find the center of this. Be careful. Kind of get it started a little bit. Go ahead, splint it right down the center, like so. When you have two matching pieces. Okay, so next thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go ahead and bring this up close so you can see it. Is that you notice on the inside here, I have it a concave shape on both pieces. Not very wide, you don't want it too wide. If you get too wide, then your sound pitch will go high instead of or your sound pitch will sound low instead of high like we want it now. So what we're going to do is shave out the center part of this. So I would say probably be maybe 16th of an inch gap in there or so. Leave these ends on here flat, since they're a matching set. When you put them back together, it'll give you a flatter surface to tie down on. And being careful, basically all you do, I'm not going to do it completely since I've already showed you, but you're going to hold your thumb on one place, gives you about an eighth of an inch. Start there and go ahead and start and shaving out the center on both ends, little by little, until you get your concave shape. Okay? So that's what you can do there. I'll go ahead and take this apart so I can show you how to put it back together. Okay, basically I just got a total of three rubber bands. One of them you want kind of thick like this, I guess about a 16th of an inch, or a little bit more in thickness, or width I should say. Both ends are were carved out in the center to where when you put them together you have a slight gap in there, like I showed you, slight gap that you blow through. The way you're going to set this up is you place your rubber band in the center, like so. You want them to kind of line up right down the center of your stick there. Place the other one on top, like so. Then take and hold them, pinch them in the center with your thumb and forefinger. And on one end, you want to go ahead and anchor it down by wrapping your rubber band around it several times. Then what you're going to do on the other end is tune it. If I blow through it right now, I need a higher pitch sound than that. So basically what you do is you hold, squeeze the center like this, up to the end, grab that rubber band and stretch it. We're stretching on the inside. And then pinch the end and then give it a try. You pull the rubber band, twist it over, squeeze it, and then try it out. That's a little bit too high. Okay, if you listen to quails in the nature, I'll put a quail call sound on my blog here, so you can get an idea what they sound like, and then so you can learn how to, you know, adjust your tone. If it's too high, just back off the rubber band a little bit. Okay, that's just about pretty close to the sound I want. So what I'm going to do is pull that tight again. Take my other rubber band and I'm going to anchor this side down. Now as the rubber band starts to stretch as time goes by, you may have to readjust your call there. Here you have the other end of the rubber band dangling where you can probably attach it to something so you don't lose it. And what you want to do is try blowing to both ends, because one end might sound better than the other end. Like this end sounds a whole lot better, so I'm kind of liking that. So then you're thinking that that's if you have rubber bands to do this with. But what I'm going to show you is you're thinking, well, Charlie, well, I don't have any rubber bands unless I take my socks apart or my underwear, and I can't do that because I need them because I'm out here surviving. Well, again, let me show you I can do it without the rubber bands.